a bad relationship or want to know how to keep the romance alive after 20 years? Here to help us step up our game is Chicago relationship guru Love McPherson and her husband of almost 35 years, Tony. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
We had so much to get to the last time that we're picking up where we left off because I know you asked for audience questions and a lot of people weighed in.
Love was on Facebook Live with me and a lot of people.
Good questions too.
Great questions. Mm-hmm. Let's get right into it, wouldn't you say? All right, let's do it. Here we go. If you're dating more than one person, should one share that information? This comes from Lisa.
Oh, Lisa. Absolutely. It should be of integrity within the relationship at all times.
Why did you look at me, Val?
So do we have some news to break right now?
No, we don't. No,
keep talking.
So there's no don't ask, don't tell policy.
Well, you know, if that's the relationship, you're saying,
give me a break.
You didn't say you were just dating, casually dating, because once you, there has to be a bridge between we're just every now and then going out and we're in a serious relationship. And you can't make that with two people if both people have not agreed to that. So
okay, wait a minute, hold on, Love. Okay, so dating, just like going out to dinner here, maybe one night with this one, one night with this one, one night with that. Let's just say there's a rotation.
Dating. Oh, yeah. I mean,
does that person have to inform the other people in the rotation that they're in the lineup?
You know what? I wouldn't inform them. I would not inform the people particular, like say, oh, by the way,
this
is who's on the bench and name them.
Right.
No. Okay. But what I would do is this. I'm not serious right now. I'm not ready for a serious relationship. Okay. I'm not ready for a monogamous relationship. Okay. You have to let them know where this is going. But actually, I would be asking. Absolutely. Mm. Where is this going?
But on the first date, that's a lot to ask.
Not on the first date.
Yeah.
But on the first date, it's a date. It's not your wedding.
Right. So that's my point. That's my point. So it's the first date. So it's okay if you have a date a few days later.
Oh, my goodness. Absolutely.
With another person, you mean.
Yes.
At what point usually it is the woman in the relationship, if it's a male-woman thing. Mm-hmm. At what point can the woman say, hey, where is this going? Is that like the third date? Is that the fourth date?
By the third date, I would want to know if I'm wasting my time because guess what? Every time I spend with you is an investment and there is a chance that my heart will get involved. I don't want my heart to become invested in you and you're not investing in me.
Right. Okay, so three dates. Okay.
Mm. Here we go, next. After 3 years, he still won't say he loves me. Advice, uh-oh. Jennifer.
Oh. Wait, 3 years?
Okay, so let me tell you about that. This can go two different ways. First, it could be a thing where in his household, people just have never expressed, I love you. He's never heard his parents say it. There's just not that language that is expressed openly. Okay, that can be one thing. The second thing is maybe he doesn't love you. And if he doesn't love you, and this is the thing. What the problem is not that he has not said he loves you. The biggest problem is why is it that you have not had that conversation yet? Why is it that you are not able to speak openly and honestly with someone to find out why or if you love me? And if you love me, then you should know by now that he's just not able to express his emotions. And if he's not able to express his emotions or she's not able to express her emotions, guess what has happened? The question you have to ask yourself is, can my love cover this?
But Tony, do you think after 3 years you can just, like, even if he's not saying it, that he has to love her, right? Or is it possible for somebody not to love somebody after 3 years?
But it's actually chiseled in his heart. 3 years is a long time. The foundation is really coming from a household or he's been conditioned like that. He has never stepped up to the plate. Is it a fear that's inside his heart?
Yeah.
The saying that, no, I can't do this. I cannot do this. But why?
So she shouldn't give up on him. She should just address it.
She has to address it, and she should have addressed it 2.5 years ago.
Okay, I'm gonna go with this one. This one's from Lisa. What do you do when your kids hate the person you are with? How do you blend a new person into the family?
Mm. I will say that if a person is hating the person you're with, one of the things that you want to know is why does the kid hate that person? Is it because that person is trying to act like their parent? is that person, do they think that they always had the hope that their parents were going to get back together, and this is why?
Or what if it's from the one parent poisoning that person?
So it can be a lot of reasons why that person hates the person. However, this is what the biggest issue, and this is, what is the parent that is involved in this relationship going to make a decision to do? Because if you're going to marry that person, you have to be able to, don't ever marry somebody you can't trust with your kid. If you think that that person cannot love that kid because they're going through some things and they'll treat them in a certain way, well then, you know, that's a problem, because you all have to be a united front. Now, you need to learn parent. You need to discuss parenting styles, because the person who is being hated, they can come from this a parenting style where kids should be seen and not heard. So you need to just sit down and shut up. I got your mother and you need to deal with it. You know, that kind of thing.
What about if a kid is manipulative though in the situation, and what message does that send to the new spouse, right? So let's say the new spouse is doing everything right, wants the kids to love them, him or her, but then the parent, the other parent, then sides with the kids. That means the kids are winning over the other person. What message does that send to the other lover in the situation?
And here's the thing. You don't have to have a stepchild to do that. You can have real children to do that, okay, who try to manipulate parents. However, what you have to do is this. My husband and my kids are on two different tracks. First of all, my children, the day I push them out of my stomach, is they're on their way out the door. Everything I do will design to get them out the door safely and securely, okay? Everything I do here is designed to keep him in the door, okay? So that's where we part. So therefore, I'm not going to side with my kids against my husband.
Right.
The more secure this foundation is, the more secure my children will be. This is here. Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
I just want to see a little smooch to end this segment.
Yeah.